Dear Swifties, crucify me for my opinions. Crucify me for what I think of one song. That is in no way over Taylor Swift's entire discography. Me personally, I separate the artist from the music. No bullshit. What's up? Here I am, reacting to the shitty song. Let's see if you can put diamonds on this shit, encrust this shit in gold. Out of all the Taylor Swift songs, and for this one to be a diss track or whatever it is, she did better stuff on her last album with Bad Blood. That was a big move for her, and that moved her career in a different way. Like, that's how you make a good song. And for you to have like a 2-3 year hiatus and to release a song like this, that's just... That's a bad move? Is it a bad move? I don't know. You know it's going to get attention, but it's going to tear your credibility down, don't you think? It's going to tear her credibility down. You know, it's not money moves in my head. It's just kind of like bad attention. But anyway, let's get into this music video and see what it's going to give, because it could easily just change my opinion. Yes, the song is stuck in my head. Yes, it's catchy. Yes, it's annoying. That's what it is. Anyway, enough. Let me just get right to this music video. Okay. Haunted house Halloween vibe. Graveyard. Here lies the body of the love of my life, whose heart I broke. Hell. Snake rings. Okay, Taylor, it always gives a flawless visual. Y'all know that. Come on, hair. Come on, snakes. Brute. All these signs, tea, sips tea, queen sips tea. Look what you made me do. Bitch, bitch. I thought that was an Ariana diss for a second. Okay, Miley Cyrus, I Can't Be Tamed, Britney Spears, Circus. She's gorgeous. I love Taylor's. Another drama. This is like almost like K-pop video worthy, like 21 or something. I just feel like the song is just not her. The song is mm-mm, girl. The visuals are just doing something to me. Taylor, what you doing to me? Come on, Todrick. Yes. Let's get in gentrification, bitch formation. Okay, see, this is how you do it. You don't, I feel like if she just did a Beyonce move and just dropped the motherfucking music video, then that would have been the T. That would have been the T for T Swift. 13. What do these symbols mean? Rep, reputation. Oh my God, are these old Taylors? Okay, that's from her tour, I'm pretty sure. That's, we all know that one. You Belong With Me. Country Day is my favorite. Cause she's dead. Come on, visuals. Save the day, bitch. Come on, coochie cutter, bitch. Yes. God, come on, queen. See. Aw, y'all. Taylor. Bruh. Shake it off. Bruh! Taylor, T-Swifty! That's how you do it. That's how you do it. Okay. Look, listen, girl. I stand corrected a little bit. Okay, I stand corrected. I'll just admit to that. This song, I can't get into it. I gotta work it up. But with this visual, it gives me a whole bunch of inspiration. It just shows how media visually can change something entirely. Images can just change your whole mood. And I get the messages. These are all different versions of yourself. Old you, former you, your personalities. And y'all caught that bitch saying, "Don't call me that." Referring to personal life drama. But I mean, I guess that's kind of doing it the Beyoncé way, putting your personal life into your music, but this is in a different way. Anyway, this visually is the right way to do it. Song is catchy, I'll give it that. Low-key bop, not really. The song is okay. The song is good. Oh my god, why am I fighting this? Why am I fighting this? I'm not fighting this. Leave some albums down below that you want me to react to. I've never heard a full Taylor Swift album, only her singles, and they have slayed me until she dropped this one. But if I saw the music video first, then, or if the music video were to have been dropped out of nowhere, boom, Beyonce, it would have all been a different story. Anyway, guys, like this video, subscribe, leave a comment down below, let me know what you think. Yeah, guys, how'd I do? I survived. Anyway, peace out. Look what you made me do. Look what you made.